Welcome to my third class about deep policy search. In this class, I'm presenting the TRPO and PPO algorithms, which are particular algorithms from the policy gradient approach. So let's start with TRPO. Actually, if you want to understand this class, you have to have a look at the previous class where I'm explaining the basics of policy gradient methods. So we established in the previous class that the standard policy gradient algorithm for stochastic policies uses this formula for the gradient. So you apply an expectation of the log gradient of the policy times some advantage function. This is what we have shown in the previous class. One point is that this can be challenging to compute the advantage function for the policy that you are currently improving. I mean the one on which you are applying the gradient descent. So it's challenging to compute this advantage while optimizing over theta. So we will rather try to compute the advantage using the previous policy P theta hold as shown here. The other point is that the gradient information, this gradient information, is not changed if we divide it by a constant. And actually we can divide this term by this constant, because that's the old policy, which is not changed, which we change the theta. So those values are just probabilities, we do not change over time. This is previous stuff. Okay. So rather than optimizing this, we can rather optimize this objective, where we have divided this term by this one, and changed the advantage function by the advantage function over the old policy. Okay. And the idea is that if we optimize using this formula rather than this one, then we will get something that is very similar to policy gradient methods. You can get another derivation of using this method based on important sampling, because here you can recognize an important sampling term, but I won't go into the details. Again, if you want to understand those points in more details, I urge you to see John Schulman's DeepRL Bootcamp lecture number 5, where here you have a link to this particular video. Okay, so the idea of TRPO is to use the previous objective that I've just presented to you, and also to add a trust region mechanism. So what's this? The idea is that computing a gradient is only accurate close to the current thing that you are, with respect to which you are computing a gradient. So here, the gradient of P theta is only accurate close to the current policy P theta. So we should not move too far away from P theta, otherwise the gradient computation won't be accurate. Thus, when we update the new policy, we must move away from a trust region around this current policy. This mechanism is used in many reinforcement learning algorithms, and in particular deep reinforcement learning algorithms like REPS from Ian Peters, etc. And so as to make sure that you will stay close to the current policy, what TRPO does is that it uses a natural gradient update instead of a standard gradient update. So the idea is that it will minimize a Kullback-Libert divergence between the current policy and the previous policy. And minimizing this divergence means that you won't move too far away from the previous policy, which is what we want. And it can be shown, I won't explain this into this class, but I need some in the future to prepare a class about advanced gradient methods such as natural gradient methods. So you can show that if you minimize the Kullback-Libert divergence between the current policy and the previous one, in fact what you are doing is following the natural gradient. Okay, that's also comes from here. So once we have added the trust region concern into the previous optimization problem, so we have the optimization problem that we want to maximize to find the Rmax over theta of this expectation, but we add the constraints that the Kyle divergence between the old policy and the current policy is should stay inferior to a parameter delta. Okay, so how can we solve such an optimization problem? In fact, in the TRPO algorithm, John Schulman uses a conjugate gradient method, which allows it allows you to perform this computation without having to approximate a Fisher information matrix, given that the Fisher information matrix is in the side of the policy parameters. And if your policy is a deep neural network, your vector of parameters is very, very large, so you have a huge matrix and you cannot afford to compute this Fisher information matrix. So the conjugate gradient method is a technique that allows you to avoid this very expensive computation. By the way, we also need to approximate disadvantage functions. So we need an empirical estimate of the value function. So we need this estimate of the value function, which is a critic. So in fact, trust region policy optimization is an actor critic method as soon as you use this baseline. Okay, and it's not a direct policy search method as it is sometimes written in some papers that get this wrong. Okay. By the way, also, in this technique, we use Monte Carlo samples from the previous policy. So the method is on policy because it has to generate new samples each time a new policy is computing. It's computed, so it cannot use samples coming from a different policy. Otherwise, your estimate of the advantage would be wrong. Okay. Final important point is that in TRPO, they are using a line search method to tune the gradient step size, which is critical in the good performance of TRPO, because tuning the gradient step size is difficult and doing line search is an expensive but accurate method for doing so. So finally, TRPO is an algorithm that performs well in practice, which is more stable than DDPG, but is less sample efficient because it's on policy, so it cannot reuse the samples many times, and it is quite slow to converge. So it is more, you can more easily compare TRPO to evolutionary methods than to DDPG, for instance. But we will move in the next steps with PPO and then SAC to something which is much closer to DDPG. So what's PPO? In fact, these are two algorithms. In fact, the paper is entitled Proximal Policy Optimization Algorithms with an S, and in fact there are two algorithms, which is not much explained in the explanatory tutorials that I've seen before, so in a few videos, for instance. So the point of the first point with the first algorithm is that the conjugate gradient method of TRPO is not available in deep learning libraries, so it's quite complicated to write a TRPO algorithm by yourself because you have to implement this conjugate gradient method. So the idea of PPO is, if we want to remove this conjugate gradient method, we can use a soft constraint on the trust region rather than a hard one, which will make it possible to switch to using standard gradient descent techniques. So instead of solving this problem, which was the problem solved by PPO, we rather use this problem. So instead of solving this optimization problem with this as a constraint, we rather try to optimize this minus this term, so that if this term goes big, then the optimization will not be very efficient. Okay. And I won't again go into the technical details of why this is a good idea to do so, but if you do so, you will be able to use stochastic gradient descent instead of using conjugate gradient. The point is that you will have to tune this parameter beta so as to enforce the trust region constraints without being too detrimental to the performance of the policy that you are looking for. Okay. So that's the first algorithm. The second algorithm is based on a different idea. The idea is that in TRPO, the importance sampling term, which is here, may get huge if p theta old is very small, which happens if your new policy is exploring states where the actions in states where it has a very low probability. Okay. So in that case, what you can do is, if the term here is huge, you can just clamp it. So you write R of theta is this importance sampling term, okay? And if your advantage function is positive, then if the value of R goes higher to 1, then you just clip it. So you don't continue along this line. You just say, I won't go further over that particular value if R gets larger again. And in the case where the advantage function is negative, you do the same in the other way. If you want to have clearer explanation of why we are doing this, you could have a look at the PPO video from the Archive Insight website, where you have a quite nice explanation of this mechanism. And then once you have used this formula with clipping instead of just using R of theta, then you can backpropagate the loss corresponding to that through your policy network, and you will get something that is similar to TRPO, but which is much simpler to write in terms of piece of code. Okay, so PPO is a quite, this version of PPO is a very simple version of a policy gradient algorithm, and it performs better than TRPO in most cases. So that's a good idea to use this. And PPO for a long time was, okay, for 1 year, let's say, was the state of the art algorithm in the deep reinforcement learning domain. So a few properties of PPO. One point is that instead of using Monte Carlo to compute the advantage, it rather uses some n-step return, so it's more step-based than TRPO. It gets closer to DDPG, where all you can also use n-step return based on a replay buffer. Okay. Also, as I just told you, it's the implementation is much simpler than the one of TRPO, and it performs better. But the point is that PPO is still on policy because you have to compute the performance of the new policy based on samples from that particular policy. You cannot use samples from a previous policy, and the different policies cannot differ much. Okay. Let's mention also that lots of parallel versions of PPO exist. In fact, it is shown, as in the case of DDPG, that if you are using several workers, so several agents to collect samples, you can get something that explores better and that performs better. The point here is that, by contrast with DDPG, you don't have a replay buffer where these actors can put the samples together. So the way to implement that is a little different. Okay. And that's it for TRPO and PPO. I know that this is quite a short introduction, but there is a lot of material on the web, like John Schulman's video in the DeepRL Bootcamp and the Archive Insight video about PPO, where you can find additional information about these algorithms. And next I will explain to you SAC, and here there is much less material at the moment. Thank you for listening.